a great day. I don't know what to say other than I was this close to getting what would have been one of the biggest wins of my career. And man, that would have been really special, but it wasn't in the cards today. My team's done an excellent job over the last few weeks of, you know, hitting their marks and executing on all fronts, no mistakes, and solid cars. And I'm very proud of that. Just extremely proud of that. We're in a great position as a team as the chase is about to start here to make some noise, and I'm just feeling lucky to be there. But then, of course, we obviously want to win, and I can taste the legitimacy of being a championship contender, and with a little more speed, I think today we could have got us a win, and I know in the chase we can get us a bunch of them. So I'm just proud of where we're at and ready for the chase to get going, but a little bit more speed, and, man, I feel like we could have had it today, so it's hard not to think about that, but a great effort by my guys to get us where we were, and I'm very, very proud of that. If anything, you should be more upset now about not winning than even still in the chase, because those bonus points mean a lot for the chase. Where consistent solid place finishes without risking a bad day probably means, whoa, that's the first time I'd seen that.
Yeah.
Jeez.
Said it just like sliced right into the car.
My God. But consistent days and finishes in the chase are extremely important. So, you know, you'll probably be happier with second in the chase than what you would even be here today. That's kind of my opinion on that. But this is my home track. I want to win here just as bad as I want to win a race in the chase, probably more. So there was a stretch where I felt like we were going to win it, and I had some goosebumps going on. But, it wasn't meant to be, and I'm still very proud of the effort. I didn't know how much Jimmy had been holding back. And when he pushed the trigger right there when he passed me, it was clear that he'd been holding back a lot. It's hard to know those things. You never know how hard a driver is pushing. But obviously he wasn't going 100%, and when he did, he was clearly the class of the field. So that was quite a sight to see. The 48 has the most speed and the best history as far as the chasing is concerned. But it's my job to not roll over and give it to him. And we're doing everything we can do, and we nailed it on that last green flag sequence. And I'm proud as hell of my guys for doing that. And although they might have the most speed, we're not giving up. And we're going to make them – we're going to keep them honest through this chase. And that's our goal. And I think it's good to know that they're frustrated, because they should be. we nailed it. And hopefully while they keep working on the other things, we'll find that little bit of speed to go with the execution we have and be in even better condition to close the deal out. So we just got to keep pushing in that sense. We caught a lucky break that was unfortunate for Jimmy with him not getting those bonus points for a win, but he definitely deserved to win the race. It just didn't play out that way. But the 48 might be the favorite for the champion, but we're not going to roll over and just let him have it.